While meeting the Uganda Parliamentary Press Association at Parliament today, Dennis Hamson Obua, the government chief whip, hinted on the need for the public to start discussions around downsizing Parliament, which is exerting pressure on the public funds. Obua sees no harm in having each district represented by two MPs, one man and one woman, to replace constituency MPs.
What is wrong with a district being represented by two members of Parliament? One male, one female. I think this discussion is healthy. But on the question of deciding, I do not have that power.
The creation of new constituencies in 2020 saw the size of Parliament swell from 426 seats of the 10th Parliament to 557 seats in the 11th Parliament. Every financial year, the taxpayer spends over 600 billion shillings, which is close to 2 billion shillings per day in running Parliament. Obua believes that the proposal to downsize the August House can only be digested by the soon-to-be-appointed Constitutional Review Commission. He urged Ugandans who think that the current parliament is too big to prepare their views and submit them during the process of the constitutional review.
Article 1 of the constitution says power belongs to the people. When that commission is constituted, the commission will consult the people of Uganda, including yourself and myself. And the people of Uganda will express their views on areas in our national constitution where they think should be reviewed through a repeal, through an amendment. If the question of the size of parliament comes up, I believe this is something that will be subjected to an evidence-based submission, just like I've given my example. So I alone, I can't do it. I do not have that power. But when that commission is constituted, they will consult the people of Uganda.
Meanwhile, Government Chief Whip Dennis Hamson Obua also defended ministers in the Iron Sheet scandal and urged Ugandans to resist from implicating them before investigations are concluded. Obua noted that it's wrong for Ugandans to castigate and condemn ministers who just received Iron Sheets as a donation.
You tell me I received a donation of 300 Iron Sheets, and I further distributed them to six government-aided schools in a Leptong district, in a Ajuri county, and they acknowledge receipt. I will ask you, under the laws of Uganda, what offense would I committed? So let's respect all these principles. We know that currently there are investigations going. Why don't we respect that process? Allow the ministers in question go and participate in the investigations. The investigating authority will determine who is culpable and who is not culpable, who is a suspect and who is a witness, basing on the facts and evidence adduced during the process of investigations.
The ministers implicated in the scandal include himself, Hamson Obua, Finance Minister Matia Kasaija and his deputies Amos Lugorobi and Henry Musasizi, the Karamoja Affairs Minister Mary Goretti Chitutu and her deputy Agnes Nandutu, State Defense Minister Jacob Oboth Oboth, State Minister for Primary Education Moriko Kaduchu, among others. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.